Welcome to Animator. This video introduces a new type of camera called camera around. It allows to make traveling around an object or a set of objects. So for instance, here you see that we go around the solid. Let's create a camera around with this model. So we create a new camera. The camera around is this small icon, so you click on it and you have a number of options. Basically, you need to do three things. One is to select the objects. Okay, by default, Animator selects the whole model. The second thing is to select the type of contour. So here we have convex hull, which goes basically around all the object, but you can do a circle, ellipsis, rectangle as well. So for example, here with a rectangle, we have the closest rectangle around the two villas. Okay, and the third thing is to select your camera viewpoint, the initial one. So for example, let's say we are happy to start with this viewpoint, or we can, let's say, take this one, and when it is done, you capture the camera. Now, if you run the animation, here it goes fast. You go around the two villas. If you wish to select a particular object, so let's for example select this villa, you click on object, you select the villa, and when you finish your selection, you could select other object, you click finish selection. So now the path, the camera path is around this villa only. So let's take a circle or maybe an ellipsis, which is more appropriate. Let's start with an initial viewpoint, capture the camera, and we can go around for the visit of the villa. The speed at which the camera will travel is determined either by the time you allocate for a full round or by a speed. Okay, so it all depends on what you want. For example, here we can go by speed and take a slower path, let's say 15 meter by second. Okay, the villa is big, so therefore, if now we go with this speed, we have a much smoother movement around the villa. So another feature which can be useful, so let's go to the initial part, is to play with the path itself. So first you can reverse it. So if you reverse it, you go the other ways, obviously. You can also determine a portion of the path. So here is the start, and you can say I want to go from 10% of the path to, let's say, 50%, 70%. Okay, so here you see that the camera will circle between this start point and this end point. So this can be useful, for example, if you wish to have several sequences, each with a portion of the path. You can play with the camera path with two options. One is the offset, which you can increase like this, or decrease. Okay, so these are adjustment you make. It's function also of the viewpoint you choose, so it really depends. For paths which are not ellipses or circle, but for example a rectangular path, you can also, in addition to changing the offset, like this, you can round the corners. So here, for example, I will round the corners. They are rounded with squircles. So now you get a smoother treatment of the turns. With this option. Obviously, in practical situations, you will not go that fast. Here we have a speed which is 28 meters by second, so almost three times the speed of Usain Bolt. Usually, you would take something like 5 meters per second, which already is a good walk, and therefore you would obtain something smoother, where you can negotiate the turns much better. You will notice that animator try to slow down in the turn. It's not perfect at the moment. I will try to improve this feature. So that's about it for camera around. There are other possibilities, like you can be inside a building and with a very small path and a positioning of the camera, look around outside. Okay, so you can play with it, but I'll probably come up with a dedicated camera, panoramic camera for that. Okay, thank you very much, and enjoy Animator and SketchUp.